How does Peter Gallagher really feel about his former OC castmates? Which fan favorite loves the idea of an OC reboot, but has no intention of acting in it? And what actually happened to Misha Barton? Hi, I'm Janet, and you're watching OSA. Let's get started. Peter Gallagher as Sandy Cohen. Credited with having the best eyebrows in the biz, Gallagher's career breakthrough came in Sex, Lies, and Videotape. Next up was the 90s box office hit While You Were Sleeping. Yet his career rocketed to the next level when he became beloved TV dad and lawyer Sandy Cohen. Does Gallagher share Sandy's loving nature when it comes to his relationship with his former castmates? Or does he avoid them whenever possible? Of course not. However, he does admit that he was worried about them during the show, as first fame can be deadly. He revealed that he had, quote, a few discussions about how one should behave with his young co-stars, but it came out of a place of concern. Although the show ended 14 years ago, yes, it's been that long, Gallagher still makes a point to stay in touch with his younger castmates. I love those kids, he told People magazine last year. I root for them always. Don't you just love a close-knit cast? In any case, after the show wrapped, Gallagher remained a familiar face, playing recurring roles on shows including Grace and Frankie and Zoe's Infinite Playlist. In real life, Gallagher and his wife Paula Harwood have achieved something rare in Hollywood circles. Can you guess how long they've been happily married? Don't worry, we won't keep you in suspense. 38 wonderful years. Want to hear how they met? You got it.
I adore my wife. I met her first week of freshman year in college, you know,
and cool.
We didn't go out right away, which was, I was too nervous and geeky.
But ultimately, they realized they were meant for each other. The couple share two adult children, and it looks like talent runs in their family. Yeah, their daughter, Katherine Gallagher, is an actress and singer who starred in the Alanis Morissette Broadway musical, Jagged Little Pill. This year, the production earned her and the cast a Grammy for Best Musical Theater Album. She has one proud papa. Katherine often chats about what it's like being the daughter of the real-life Sandy Cohen. She once revealed that, like the Coens, the Gallaghers are also very into their bagels. In fact, she recently shared a TikTok video which included an inside bagel joke from the OC.
So one question that I always get is, what's it like having Sandy Cohen as a dad, and is he really like that in real life? And he's just my dad.
Hey, Catherine, I shared it for you.
Aw, Sandy Cohen, we miss you. Kelly Rowan as Kirsten Cohen. Playing Sandy's recovering alcoholic wife, Kirsten, model and actress Kelly Rowan grew up in Canada. After a successful career as a teen model, she broke into acting. Among her many early roles, she guest starred in legendary soapy Dallas and appeared in Steven Spielberg film Hook. She also impressed critics in her award-winning performance in the Canadian TV film Adrift. Yet it was the OC that cemented her stardom. While she said the show definitely opened doors, it didn't bring as many opportunities as one would expect. She once admitted to Nouveau magazine, "When you are on such a popular show, you become more recognized everywhere, even when you're traveling internationally," she said during the show's four-season run. But honestly, the phone is not ringing off the hook with offers. During her years on the OC, Rowan began working on the other side of the camera, serving as a producer on a number of TV movies. When the OC came to an end in 2007, Rowan decided on a change of pace, announcing she was taking some time out for herself. That may have had something to do with her love life, as the year also marked her engagement to Canada's wealthiest man, David Thompson. Sadly, the couple ended their engagement shortly before Rowan gave birth to their now 13-year-old daughter. A few years after the OC wrapped, Rowan starred alongside Will and Grace star Eric McCormick in the crime series Perception. The actress last appeared in a TV movie in 2016, but the years since then remain a bit of a mystery. Adam Brody as Seth Cohen. Brody brought Rowan and Gallagher's awkward but lovable on-screen teenage son to life, a cute nerd who ultimately landed the girl of his dreams. The Seth Cohen character developed somewhat of a cult following. Don't you miss him? Fans also loved the fact that Brody was actually dating Rachel Bilson, who played his love interest, Summer Roberts. The co-stars split a year before the show ended, but they got their on-screen happily ever after. Seth Cohen became known as TV's sexiest geek and was also famous for coining the now popular term Chrismica to combine his parents' different religious traditions. In a recent hilarious quiz, Brody even picked Chrismica as the OC moment that hits him right in the feels.
I'm gonna go Chrismica because that seems to make a lot of people happy. That gave, you know, that helped popularize a holiday.
Although the OC was undeniably Brody's big break, he previously landed a recurring role in the hit series Gilmore Girls, among other projects. During the OC's run, his film career flourished, and he even played a supporting role in Mr. and Mrs. Smith. In the 14 years since the AOC Wrapped, there's been no slowing down for the actor. He starred in numerous films, including the superhero action comedy Shazam, and in 2020's most disturbing award winner, Promising Young Woman. He's also been in many TV series, including the crime drama Startup. Over the years, there's been much talk of an OC revival, and Brody's all for it. Can we dare hope? Don't get too excited. Although the actor loves the idea of a reboot, he wouldn't want to be in it. I was happy at the time, and I'm proud of the work I did, and I'm proud we got to be a part of pop culture, he told GQ magazine, but it's not something that interests me in terms of revisiting. Brody's come a long way since the days of Seth Cohen. Not only is he a successful actor, he's also a husband and father. In a real-life teen series crossover that thrilled fans, he married Gossip Girl star Leighton Meester in a secret ceremony in 2014. The two met on the set of the indie comedy The Oranges, hooked up a while later, but kept their relationship on the down low for as long as possible. Now happily married, they recently became parents to their second child, Rachel Bilson as Summer Roberts. Brody's former on-screen and real-life girlfriend, Rachel Bilson, comes from a long line of directors, producers, and screenwriters. Before landing the role of Summer on The OC, Bilson guest starred in TV shows, including Buffy the Vampire Slayer. The OC made the actress a star, but having Brody for support kept her grounded. In a recent interview with Nylon, she said she'll always be grateful for their three-year relationship. Because of what this show was and how young we all were, going through it with someone experiencing the same thing and having that kind of support was really awesome, she said. Bilson was in fact initially only hired to appear on a few episodes of The OC, but she brought something special to the role, and producers decided to make her a permanent fixture. She was adorable, funny, and smart, which was a really fresh way to go with that character, said series creator Josh Schwartz. Schwartz later produced the comedy drama series Heart of Dixie, in which Bilson played the main character. After the show wrapped, she joined the cast of Nashville, where she acted with former OC castmate Chris Carmack. Bilson has also been in a number of movies, including sci-fi action film Jumper, alongside her now ex, Hayden Christensen. The two share a six-year-old daughter. The actress also dated comedian Bill Hader, but the couple called it quits in 2020. One relationship she's not ready to let go of? Her one with the OC fans. Like us, Bilson longed for a series reunion, so she grabbed the opportunity to make it happen. Teaming up with co-host Melinda Clark, who played Marissa's mother, Julie Cooper, she recently kicked off an Apple podcast, aptly named Welcome to the OC, Bitches. The podcast, which launched in April 2021, features the cast and creators as guests who reminisce about episodes and share behind-the-scenes scoops. We can't wait to see all it has to reveal. Ben McKenzie as Ryan Atwood. Playing a troubled teen from the wrong side of the tracks, Texas native Ben McKenzie captured many a young girl's heart. The unknown stage actor went from waiting tables and sleeping on a friend's floor in LA to becoming the lead on one of TV's hottest shows. The massive fame that came with The OC required some adjustments for both him and his young castmates.
It was a rocket ship, and I think we all kind of hung on for dear life.
During his time on The OC, McKenzie broke into movies, playing a role in the critically acclaimed comedy drama Junebug. Once the show wrapped, more film roles followed. His TV career took off too. In 2009, the actor landed the part of a rookie cop in the TV series Southland. He later starred in the Batman prequel, Gotham. McKenzie also directed and wrote a few episodes of the series. More recently, he's returned to where he first began his acting journey, the theater, starring on Broadway just before the COVID-19 lockdown. On the set of Gotham, McKenzie met his now wife, actress Morena Baccarin. At the time, the actress was married to Austin Chick, a film producer and director. Baccarin actually fell pregnant with McKenzie's baby during her somewhat messy divorce proceedings with Chick, and that's not the only shocking part of the couple's story. Baccarin, in fact, once guest starred on The OC, but didn't share a scene with her future husband. The two did cross paths, but McKenzie had no memory of the meeting. Can you believe it?
To his credit, he was, you know, a 20-year-old hotshot who just gotten his first great job, and he was all that, right?
Right.
So I told him it's his fault. I mean, he missed me in my prime. You know, he could have had this a lot sooner.
They've certainly made up for lost time. Like his former co-star Adam Brody, McKenzie became a father for the second time this year. It's wonderful to watch him every day with our kids, Baccarin recently told People magazine. I couldn't ask for a better partner. Seems Ryan Atwood's come a long way. Misha Barton as Marissa Cooper. By the time she was 13, Misha Barton had earned rave reviews for her theater performances and had acted in films including Notting Hill, Lawn Dogs, and The Sixth Sense. The OC took her career to the next level, gaining widespread fame playing the rebellious, emotionally unstable Marissa. The actress was named the It Girl of 2003 by Entertainment Weekly. Yet just 3 years later, she made the decision to leave the show. While rumors swirled about the reasons behind her departure, it seems it was mainly a professional decision. "I just had a lot in my career that I wanted to do and accomplish," she revealed in 2019. "I felt like things were really heavily reliant upon me, and I was getting no time to do any of the other offers that were out there." She also said she was no longer enjoying being a part of the show. Barton went back to England after her OC exit at the end of season 3 and spent a year doing some self-exploration. But Barton seemed to share Marissa's dangerous habits and was ultimately arrested for driving under the influence. She was also later temporarily placed under psychiatric care. The actress also had a very public falling out with her mother when she sued her in 2015. Barton claimed that her mom kept a disproportionate amount of her earnings and exploited her fame. She later dismissed the suit. And judging by her emotional 2020 Mother's Day Insta post, the two have since reconciled. While Misha admitted that mother-daughter relationships aren't always easy, she added, "We've walked all over this planet together, Mama, and I'm so proud to call you my mom. I love you with all my heart and soul." Over the years, the actress has appeared in a handful of movies and TV shows, including a reboot of the reality show The Hills: New Beginnings. But she's never repeated the kind of success she achieved on The OC. While she says they've lost touch, Rachel Bilson recently expressed her desire to host Barton on her podcast. We're holding thumbs that it happens. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, why not check out this one featuring another beloved teen series, Gossip Girl. Stay awesome.